Hello everyone, Derek Johnson with Tatango.com. Today I'm doing an RCS chatbot demo with SeatGeek. So let's jump right into it. I have a new Samsung device, essentially right out of the package. This is a Galaxy S9, and this is on the AT&T network. So if you want access to the chatbot directory, the RCS chatbot directory, you have to be on the AT&T network and have a Samsung device. Most of the new Samsung devices are RCS enabled. Then what's really, really cool is you just click messages and then you click chatbots and that's all. You don't need to download anything, activate anything. It's right there. And as you can see, this is your conversation. So usually friends and family are kind of in this area. And you have your contacts, which also has chatbots, my chatbots, and then chatbots here. Pretty big real estate that Samsung and AT&T are giving chatbots, because look, you know, this is essentially all of these different tabs have some form of a chatbot in there. So as you can see from the screen here, there's a bunch of chatbots, about a handful or maybe a dozen right now. 1-800-Flowers, CNN, Express, Kroger, Walgreens, Warby Parker. So some really top name brands are already in the RCS chatbot directory. As I said, we're going to go and look at SeatGeek. I'm going to click SeatGeek, and it says millions of tickets in one place. It has the really nice logo, their blue background. I can call them. I can add this to my favorites. You saw that in the contact section. I'll show you real quick. You can see SeatGeek is there. I'm going to click from my favorites to go there really quickly. And I'm going to click chat. And this is going to start off the chatbot experience. This essentially triggers the chatbot to start chatting with me. So right off the bat, you have on the top left-hand corner, instead of a short code, which is a 5-to-6-digit phone number, you have actually the brand name being displayed, which is, I think, a much better experience for the consumer, because most consumers don't know that a 5- or 6-digit phone number is associated with a brand. And then the very, very left-hand side, you can see the SeatGeek logo instead of, you know, this little guy that usually you see when you get a message from a short code, this kind of grayed out person. So, hey, this is SeatGeek and they're using emojis. Tap the event type you're interested in checking out. And what's really cool is actually these things at the bottom are buttons. So I can actually click on one of these buttons, which again, you can't do in an SMS or MMS message. And I can see what happens. So I'm going to click, let's do sports. And what actually that button is doing is it's disappearing and then it's firing off a MO message, mobile originated, because it's coming from the mobile phone. And it's firing off the message sports with emoji. And then SeatGeek is going, oh, we just got a message. It says sports emoji with the ball. We need to send back a specific message. And this is what they sent back. And look, it's really optimized for RCS. They have a really nice image, and you can click on the image and expand it if you want. Then they have the title, and they're centering the title here, sports tickets, and then buy now. So I can click this, and then it goes to the SeatGeek mobile website. I'm not sure if I download the mobile app, if it'll go to the mobile app, but a lot of brands are using that kind of functionality if the customer has downloaded the app. So maybe not what I'm looking for. Let's do, oh, so it knows that I can get the app if I want there. Let's do concerts. And what's interesting, you see how it's loading here? I might not have the best connection right now, but it's loading because it's actually going out. SeatGeek is not actually sending the file to my phone. That takes a lot of bandwidth to do that, and that slows down messaging. What RCS does, it actually pings the host site and says, hey, show me that photo. So these files and these bundles of files are very small. Kind of like a website, how a website renders. So really interesting, definitely different than MMS. And again, I can just keep going through. It's a pretty simple chatbot, as you can see. But what's nice, when I click buy now, it goes to the Broadway section of SeatGeek. It doesn't just kick me to their website. So really cool experience to kind of test things out. I can click get the app. And then, I go to the Android store, the Google Play store, and I would download the app. So that's pretty much it. But cool experience and cool kind of to see, you know, the buttons, the RCS carousel. They're not using multiple carousels here. This is just one. But you can see it's a really snappy type experience and kind of fun. And, you know, maybe I'd go through and look at these and go, you know, maybe I would like, you know, a concert. And then I'd go to their mobile website, which obviously they have a mobile website. They've had it for a long time. They built everything out here. It's really beautiful. So they're looking at it kind of as RCS as a lead source for their mobile website and for their app. And given the fact that AT&T and Samsung have given so much screen real estate to their chatbots, I bet SeatGeek is getting a lot of brand new customers going, looking through these and going, oh, SeatGeek, never heard of them. You know, and starting a chat with them and essentially then kicking them to their mobile website. So really cool experience from SeatGeek. This is their RCS chatbot in the AT&T Samsung RCS chatbot directory. If you have a Samsung phone right out of the box, it should have that directory. You can look for it as long as you're Android and AT&T. Again, my name is Derek Johnson with Tatango.com. If you have any questions about RCS, chatbots, Samsung, AT&T, let us know in the comments below. We will do our best to answer them. Thanks, everyone.